Ivermectin is an FDA-approved medication for parasitic infections. Ivermectin is widely available due to its inclusion on the WHO model list of essential medicines. It opens glutamate-sensitive chloride channel currents in helminths, and it's widely believed that this is how it kills certain parasites. It's the drug of choice for the treatment of onchocerciasis and strongyloidiasis, both of which are parasitic infections. Ivermectin is effective against several intestinal nematodes, including ascariasis, trichoriasis, and also cutaneous larva migrans, also Wuchereria bancrofti, Brugia malayi, Mansonella azardi, and Loa loa. It also is effective against scabies and head lice. So why might ivermectin work against SARS coronavirus 2, the virus that causes COVID-19? Well, once the virus gains entry into the cells of the body using the ACE2 receptor, the virus releases its messenger RNA into the cell. The cell starts to translate the messenger RNA from the virus, which starts to make viral proteins, and that's how new virus forms. But some of these viral proteins that are freshly made then enter into the nucleus of the cell, or at least are thought to do so by many scientists. And this probably impairs our cell's ability to fight off the infection. The way these viral proteins are thought to gain entry into the nucleus of our cells is through specific channels that are made out of a different protein called importin. Not important, it's importin. There's importin type alpha and type beta, or imp alpha and imp beta for short. And this is where ivermectin comes in, because ivermectin inhibits the passage of these viral proteins into the nucleus. It does so by binding to these protein channels and effectively blocking the transport of molecules through them. So this is why scientists started studying ivermectin. And here we have this article that just came out April 3rd in the journal Antiviral Research. This is a pre-proof article, meaning they've been peer-reviewed, but final publication is still pending. What these scientists found is that ivermectin significantly inhibits the SARS-2 coronavirus viral proteins in their passage from the cytoplasm into the nucleus of the cells in vitro. In vitro means this was done in a test tube or outside of a living organism. So a single dose of ivermectin had a 5,000-fold reduction in virus levels at 48 hours in cell culture. So this drug has a huge impact on this virus in vitro. And that's why the authors of the study conclude that these drugs need to be studied in COVID-19 patients, meaning in clinical trials, the same way that other drugs are being looked at in clinical trials for COVID-19, such as remdesivir, chloroquine, and hydroxychloroquine. So because ivermectin is generally considered a safe drug and is already FDA approved for other diseases, it can be repurposed for COVID-19 as long as it's shown to be safe and effective for COVID-19 in patients in these clinical trials. Now, if this drug turns out to be the miracle drug for COVID-19, the next question will become, when should it be started? In other words, at what point does someone start taking this medication? Should they take it prophylactically, or should they take it as soon as they start getting symptoms? But we're not even at that point yet. First, we have to do the clinical trials to see if it is effective for COVID-19. The other question is, what are the side effects of ivermectin, or adverse reactions? Well, based on what we already know about ivermectin, this is what I can tell you. The most common adverse reaction is the Masotti reaction. But this only happens when ivermectin is used to treat onchocerciasis, which is a parasitic infection. Now, what is the Masotti reaction, you ask? It was first described in 1948. It's a symptom complex seen in patients after undergoing treatment of nematode infestation, particularly with the medication diethylcarbamazine, or DEC for short, but it also occurs with ivermectin. Masotti reactions can be life-threatening and are characterized by fever, hives, generalized swelling, swollen lymph nodes, fast heart rate, low blood pressure, joint pain, and abdominal pain. There's a 25% chance of Masotti reaction when ivermectin is used to treat onchocerciasis, but not other parasitic infections. So if a COVID-19 patient took ivermectin, this would not happen. So otherwise, ivermectin is considered very safe and side effects are uncommon. Diarrhea occurs in about 2% of people taking it. Also, ivermectin should not be administered to pregnant or lactating women, and its safety in children who weigh less than 15 kilograms is still not known.